Yeah, good. Join me for a talk show. Yeah. How's life?
Life is going okay.
Yeah, life is just going so slow, yeah. You know, yeah, thank God. Yeah. Yeah, what's up people? Support Glassbone, Glassbone TV show episode 9. Today I'm with Fortune Cooper talking about computer science, no? Today I'm joined by Fortune Cooper. Let's talk computer science, no? Fortune, what do you know about computers? What's a computer itself?
Alright, to begin with.
Okay.
A computer, just talking about the usual definition,
okay.
We can say that a computer is a machine, that inputs data, processes, stores, and produces an output that is more useful to the human beings, since the computer itself, the language that it uses, humans can't understand.
Can't understand?
Yeah, they can't.
Okay, yeah, so you said it's a machine process data, you know, all
yeah.
Stuff
you input, it processes and stores and outputs of something that humans can understand.
Okay, yeah, unfortunately, you have seen that from the generation when computers started, you know, people are talking about computers, and even a computer age, you know, everyone is talking about computers or computer all stuff. So, but how many types of computers do you have for you?
The types of computers?
Yeah.
Okay, the number is not like fixed, like we have five or something, it's not fixed.
Mm-hmm.
But there are a number of computers that I can mention that are there. Okay, just like the planets, we are not sure if they are, is it nine?
Nine
yeah,
or ten,
we are not sure because they are still discovering.
Oh, specifically, like how many computers do you know as in types? Like,
knowing,
yeah. Don't know the
I can just mention them, like we have the personal computers, the one we call the CPs, PC.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have the supercomputers, server computers, and we have the group computers, and the list is endless.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. So which computer do you know much as in operating the base? No?
Operating.
Yeah.
Operating, that's the normal one, a PC.
A PC?
Yeah, a personal computer.
Personal computer.
Yeah, because these other computers, like the mainframes, those big computers are very expensive. And, so I just kind of like get along with the PC.
PC.
Yeah.
Yeah. So according to Fortune Cooper, like try to explain what do you know about computer itself? I mean, how do you know how to operate?
Like how I came to know about it.
Yeah. How came about to operate computer?
All right. I think computers is just determination. You know. Yeah.
How do you say that? It has a language which human people can understand.
Yeah, it has a
like
language.
Why do people operate a computer? It has that language which people can understand.
People operate a computer because it makes our work simple. Like, even if we get to what is the physics, you know, they define a machine as anything that makes human work easy. So, the computer will help human work to become easy. But about the languages, the computer uses the binary.
Binary.
It consists of what is the zeros and ones.
Mm-hmm.
And as humans, we can't understand that. That's why it is made in such a way that it's going to process. Okay, it transforms that data that you give it and produces an output, which is useful in human language.
Okay, yeah, according to basic understanding, you know about computers. Who made a computer? When was it made?
Yeah. So, if we head back, the first person to develop a computer was Charles Babbage. Yeah, Charles Babbage. Like, he was just a guy. He developed the first computer, which was analogical.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that computer didn't have a processor. Alright, okay, the processor it had, but it had no system. Yes, like nowadays we have these Windows.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, the Macintosh. But the first computer had no system, actually.
Mm-hmm.
It was operating using vacuums.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you understand about the vacuums.
No,
like
it's
yeah.
Space, no?
Yeah. Yeah. Mm. Yeah, it used to operate using the vacuums and it was very big, like very big.
Mm.
And not so many people had to afford that. It was analogical.
Mm.
Yeah, it was difficult to understand. Only guys who are intelligent, I can say brainy or computer literate, can work with that.
Yeah, so when was it made?
It was developed in 1937.
Yeah, Yeah, so like I got into the development of computers since Charles Babbage made that computer up to now, for those centuries, no? So what are some of the changes in terms of computers?
The changes yeah. There are a lot, but let me classify this. Like we have the first generation, the one with the 1937 to 1946 somewhere. There, that's the first generation. We have the Charles Babbage computer. And after that generation, you know, every generation has its unique way, like something changed, something developed. So we had the second generation, where they were, what is the ABC computer? The Anatosoft Berry computer. It was in the second generation. This one was kind of developed in terms of the size, and it also had a big processor compared to those in the first generation.
Okay.
And it could process at least two things compared to the first generation computers. They could only process one thing at a time. So these computers, instead of using vacuums compared to the first computers, they were using the transistors.
Transistors.
Yeah. Then we have the third generation computers.
Yeah.
And it's the current one.
Yeah.
Most people don't know about that, but it's the current one. The third generation computer, where we had now the most powerful computers. Like they are very small, unique. I can give an example of the ones that we're using. They are small, they can process a lot of things at the same time. So these computers consist of the operating systems. As I talked in the first place, we said an operating system. The first computers didn't have operating systems.
They're using vacuums, yeah.
Yes, they were just like very analogical. You can't even understand it. So, in the third generation computer, in terms of size, speed, even what it can hold, the RAM, the storage, became bigger as they developed. So, we had the first operating system, the MS-DOS. I don't know if people use it nowadays, but it's okay. It's very difficult. Not that difficult if you're computer literate. You can understand it. Then we had, that was the first operating system. And we had the second one, which was Macintosh. The one, the Apple system. Those iPhones, we have the MacBook. That was the second operating system to be made. Then we had the third one, the Microsoft, now Windows. This is when we bring about the story for Bill Gates.
Bill Gates, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if this generation, takes Bill Gates in a wrong way, because I don't know how I can say this, but most people think Bill Gates is the one who made the sense. He made the Microsoft, yes, and his friend, forgotten the name, they made the Microsoft the most widely used operating system in the world. It was the most widely used in the world. So that's all about the third generation computer.
Yeah, so like according to the migration of computers, no? According to the system how they operate, the differentiation, no? So like which software are you suitable with? Or which generation are you suitable in using computers? Are you comfortable in using those computers which were old?
Yeah, old.
Yeah.
Okay. For me, I think I'm comfortable. I don't know to others, but for me, I'm comfortable. The thing is just that they require a lot of attention, like using those first generation computers. You have to get like all your head, all your brains into that.
Okay, first of all, people don't understand like computer processes data. Which type of data?
Which type of data?
Yeah. That type of information is the computer process. For the people to understand the type of data.
It's the same data that we receive, like as I was saying in the first place, we input data, like it is in soft copy,
so
you can't touch it. Yeah, it is in soft copy. So if you input, the computer is going to convert it into the zeros and ones. That's the language it's going to understand. After that,
how about us humans? Which language do you understand?
Language.
If you computer can understand zeros and ones.
Yeah.
Yeah, ask people.
I think the usual language is like English, because the computer can give an output of English. The computer doesn't understand English. Yeah. it's in the background.
So like you said that, so which processes data according to the components of the computer?
Components of the computer.
Which processes the data?
One, yeah, it's the brain of the computer, which is the CPU.
CPU.
Yeah.
Okay, talk about, the CPU. How does it work?
Working. The CPU, just like the brain of humans, we have the eyes, we have the ears, so like it is, I think nowadays we have computers that we can just speak with, they hear us, like they even produce an output. So, but what is the most common computers that we are using, we just type like that. So if we type, the CPU gets the command. If it gets the command, it's going to process. There's something in that.
So
it's something.
So the CPU just works with commands.
Yeah. It's the same with the computer since it's the brain of the computer. So it works with commands. I'm taking it just like on the background, the layout. A computer can never make a mistake. So the mistake that we make is us, it's humans. They are just with the commands, like entering the commands. The computer only does what you have, as in inputted, what you have told it, what you have given it. That's what it does.
Okay.
So, yeah, the CPU is just the brain of the computer. It's going like, oh, to divide this, to do this, to output this, to do what, yeah. That's
okay,
what it does.
So like, what are the things which affect the CPU not to work? As in, this works with command. Like,
yeah.
Yourself, you're operating a computer, then the CPU has some malfunctions. No. So what do you do? What do you think affects your CPU?
The CPU.
Yeah.
The CPU can be affected by the hardware, environment. Okay, but talking about the environment, since it is inside the computer, it is put in some type of...
What's an hardware?
Like covering. An hardware.
Yeah.
An hardware is something that you can see and touch, like a component of the computer. We can see and touch. Like I can put it, if we compare with the software you can't touch it. But you can see it, you can't touch it. That's the difference between an hardware and a software. And these two things, they work hand in hand. Like if you make an hardware, a software has to be made. A software, for it to function, there has to be an hardware. Like just reprogramming, like the HTML, the C++, those languages that we use in programming, like Python. In making all these softwares, you know, developing a web page, there has to be a language. So that's with the basic layout of programming. It has languages. Those languages you have to study, just like we study in schools and what. You have to know that language. It's a language now that will make you get closer to a computer. You come to know more about computers, you come to know the background.
So like that language you're saying for programming, does it work in hand with the language with the computer uses, the zeros and ones?
It works in hand, but it's more like simplified. You can enter commands using the usual language. So it kind of like gets simple, but it's not simple. Actually in the it's not simple, but you can understand as a human, as someone who has effort on that, you can understand.
Okay, there are many types of programming, so like I'm just concerned about the programming which you know.
The programming which I know.
On the computer.
And basing on the the current situation. No, I'm actually at school. I'm not done with school, I'm in the team. So I kind of like not get it, like going deeper into programming, because it can affect my education. You know, I'm not done, I'm going to do this after school. But to what I know, I know HTML. That's for web developing and other stuff. But as time goes on, I want to learn all those, you know, the languages that we have, the Python. I'll get in details with those, because it requires a lot of attention. So it means that I have to divide school and this.
So like according to yourself, what you need, like a computer is brought up to you. So how do you use the computer? What benefit do you use the computer?
Benefit is a lot. I think it makes my work easier, like stuff. I use a computer, but first thing you have to know about the computer is that a computer can be related to human beings. Just like a baby, A baby is given everything that he or she wants. It's the same with a computer. You know, some people just want to be using the computer, like servicing, like all that, without taking the precautions, knowing what it does, what it doesn't. So, as I said in the first place, a computer can never make a mistake. But if it happens that it makes a mistake, you either check your heart, or maybe the requirements that you need, they are not enough, or maybe the software that are updated. Now, you can human.
So like, what was it?
An error by a computer can only be made if a human using it gives the command that it cannot do. Like you have a small computer and you want it to do something much.
So you said like a computer is more like a brain. So like, yeah. What makes the computer make an error? So does it make sense? The computer can't think of that thing or process that thing more than its brain.
Yeah, it can't, because since its brain is like fixed, we have computers, we have small computers, big computers, as I said, several computers, mainframes. So they have different type of processes that they can carry out. So if you give it more than it requires, it can't. Like, as I gave an example of it, maybe a child, you can't give a child to carry something bigger than he is. Definitely the child is going to fall or maybe injure himself.
So you say that the computer is more like a human being, so that's it. So in general, can you say that computers are human also?
Alright, in general, according to my own understanding, I can say they are human at an advanced level.
Advanced level?
Yeah.
But who made that computer? It's a human.
Yes, it's a human, that's what I'm saying. It's a human at an advanced level, which means it's more advanced than humans. Since we make computers, humans, we make computers. So a computer just kind of like get more advanced. You know, it can just get the... For example, I can give an example. Maybe if you say a camera, you know, the camera can get something like an image, just the correct thing, the actual thing. So like that, it can do that, even keep memories like that. Even as humans, we do keep memories, but they are not actual. If you give an output, they are not actual. But a computer can give something like from years back, just like it was then and now, it can give that.
Okay, yeah. So fortunately, like from the generation of computer where it started, no? So like do computers expire? No?
Computers expiring as in
just like you
get out of form.
Like they stop working. No?
Stop working?
Yeah.
I think they do expire.
Do you expire?
Yes, they do.
Okay, yeah, let's talk about the software. Like you said, Bill Gates made the software, the generation which you're in. Yes. So let's talk about type of software.
Type of software?
Yes, and their working.
But about Bill Gates, it was a system.
System?
Yeah, it was a system. So it's like this. We have the systems. A system is like a background, a layout of something. Then in a system, it's when we are going to have the software that will be placed in the system. So it's like a system is down, then we have softwares up there. So like if you're using Macintosh, the MacBook computers, the Apple computers, a software that can work on a Macintosh computer cannot work on a Windows computer. Like here, I have a Windows computer. I cannot go and put it on an MS-DOS operating system. It cannot work. So it's just with the system, and there's the software going the same way.
So do systems like say software, do they have that relationship with the RAM of the computer?
The RAM of the computer?
Yeah.
As I was saying, you know, the computer also needs some requirements for it to function. So that's now where we get the root of the computer making an error and something. If a computer is having maybe a 4GB RAM, then you kind of like put a software that's requiring much more bigger than that one. It's going to crash. That's an error a computer can make, and it's because of the human error.
Yeah, so what you are being that people know my computer has crashed, so now how do you, as yourself, how do you start your computer, how do you work on it,
fixing it?
Yeah, fixing it
first. Of all, I have to check what the computer requires. you know, you kind of like check the year it was made in. You just go and search, you know, utilize the internet. You just search, like you see the components of the computer, the processes it's having, and all that, the RAM. Then you see the system that you're going to put in. But generally, we have to be updating our systems. Like Windows 7 is actually out of form.
Out of form, yeah.
I don't know if people know about that, but it's out of form. On the 14th January this year, 2020, it was out of form because it was only existence for 10 years. Yeah, ever since they made it in 2009. And it has come to an end. So Microsoft does not offer support for Windows 7.
So like which system are we in up to now?
Up to now?
It's trending. Which system is trending?
It's the system which is trending. It is the Windows system, Windows 10. We have Windows 10, but the Microsoft, they have made Windows 11, but it's not yet out. They have made it, even the screenshots are there, you can see it, but it's not yet out. They are waiting for some things, but if we check, very soon it's going to be out. It's more advanced than Windows 10.
Yeah, so what's the difference in that system, no? Like with the Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10, what's the difference, no?
The difference is just maybe the something, the system, first of all, it consists of the layout space. You even know, like the way it advances, you can see that with Windows 7 is more like